Hello and welcome back, my dear children. We are back on track with our EVS classes, and this is the first session of chapter What is Cooking? In the introductory video, I ask you to do an activity given on page number 63 of your EVS book, Looking Around Us. After that, you might have explored all the treasure in the kitchen at your home. You might have seen all the utensils, and now you know what are these utensils called, how do they look, and for what purposes they are used. But do you know, children, what are the utensils made up of? In earlier times, utensils were made up of brass, bronze, copper. Earthenware was very famous. Earthenware means the utensils in the pots which are made up of mud and clay. Nowadays, people use utensils made up of steel, glass, iron, aluminium, wood, plastic. Earthenware is also used nowadays. You might be having matkas at home in which your mother stores water during the summer season. It is made up of clay. But children, we directly don't put wood on the heat and plastic on the heat. The wood can catch fire and the plastic will melt. Apart from this, I am going to tell you that the food we eat, what all food we eat, are not always prepared and consumed in the same form. The food that we eat can be eaten raw, can be eaten after cooking, and can be eaten both as raw as well as cooked. Okay, the things which we can eat in the raw form are the fruits and certain vegetables. Then the food which we need to cook before consumption are fish, meat, pumpkin, potatoes, pulses, rice. These all food items need to be cooked before consumption. Then we have the third category of the foods that can be consumed in raw form as well as in cooked form. You can see the examples on the screen, the food items: tomatoes, onions, cabbage, carrots. So,
cooking is not only meant for women, but now men are also equally involved in professions related to cooking. In fact, some famous Indian chefs like Sanjeev Kapoor, Vikas Khanna, Harpal Sokhi, and Kunal Kapoor are well known for their excellent culinary skills.
I'm going to show you another clip in which you are going to witness the materials that are required to prepare utensils, what all things which are required to produce heat, and then in detail we are going to discuss the fuels that are required to produce heat and the impact of these fuels on our environment.
There are many things that we require to cook food, like heat, utensils, and food. For cooking, the availability of heat, utensils, and raw items is essential. In villages, people used chulas and kerosene stoves. In these chulas, they produced heat by burning wood and cow dung cakes. In cities, people have many options of heat, like LPG stoves, microwave, griller, toasters, induction cookers, etc.
Now children, what you have seen in this clip is that in earlier times people used to produce heat by in chulas. And how do they produce heat? They produce heat by burning either wood or cow dung cakes. They also used kerosene stoves. Now these both have a harmful effect on our environment because they produce a lot of pollution. Nowadays, the people have switched on to better modes, better means of production of heat, which you can see on the screen. We have microwave ovens, we have induction, we have grillers, we have toasters, and then here on the top left, you can see a cooktop. This is run by LPG. Now, they also have harmful effects on the environment, but as compared to the earlier means, they are less harmful to the environment. There is one more means which is gifted to us by nature in abundance, that is sunlight. You can cook, yes, you have heard it right, you can cook and prepare food using sunlight. You need certain equipments for that, such as a solar cooker, but that method is totally harmless to the environment. It is eco-friendly.
There are many kinds of utensils that are used for cooking. These are pots, pans, spatulas, woks, spoons, pressure cooker, etc. In olden times, utensils were made up of brass, bronze, or copper. Earthenware was also popular, but it has almost disappeared now. Makhan firni, silbatta, phukni, chakki, hamam dasta are some of the names of kitchenware that were earlier used.
Okay, children, as you have seen on the screen, in the center you can see a hamam dasta. This is called a mortar and pestle in English. Rest all things also earlier were very commonly found. Now also you might found in certain kitchens. I'm going to show you a mortar and pestle. This is an updated version of this. The one given in the picture, shown in the picture, is made out of stone, and this is made up of aluminium. This we use to crush spices like black pepper, cardamom, and other things.
Do you know, sunlight is a powerful source of heat? The solar heat can be trapped in a solar cooker and can be used to cook food. It is an environmental friendly method of cooking, which is very popular nowadays. Now, let's test the idea of solar energy to melt the chocolate for a chocolate shake. Do you know, the fuel used by us to cook has a direct impact on increasing the pollution levels in the environment. Fuels like wood, coal, cow dung cakes, etc. burn and give out fumes. This in turn pollutes the environment. Even petroleum products like kerosene oil and gas affect the environment in a negative way. It's time to do something more. List down some electrical and non-electrical items that your mother uses in the kitchen while cooking. Some examples are mixer, grinder, toaster, etc., which is used to make cooking easier.
Now what you have to do, children, is you have to go and explore your kitchen once again, all the electronic items, but do it in the presence of, in the supervision of some elder person of your family. You don't have to do it in any of the classwork or practice notebook. You can note it out in rough. So all the electronic appliances which you use at home, which helps you to make your cooking process easy. Now, apart from this, children, page number 65 of your EVS book, there is a process given in it. How a chapati is prepared. It has to go through a very long process before it is served on your plate. First, the flour, with the help of water, we knead a soft dough. Out of that dough, we make small dough balls. Then we roll it on a rolling board with the help of a rolling pin. Then the chapati is cooked, only then you can consume it. You cannot consume a chapati in its raw, the flour in its raw form.
Do you know, even a simple food item such as a chapati is made after much effort? First, the flour or atta is taken out and kneaded into a smooth dough. Then small balls of dough are made, which are then rolled out and cooked on fire. So many steps are involved, isn't it? Similarly, you can list down the steps of preparation of any dish of your choice. Next time when it is cooked, write down the ingredients and the sequence of steps needed in the preparation of the dish.
In the next class, we are going to discuss about the methods of cooking in detail. Till then, you have to do page number 64 and 66 of your EVS book. The exercises given on these pages are based upon the discussions done in today's video. On page number 64, you have to note down all the food items that can be eaten raw, cooked, raw as well as cooked. And on page number 66, you have to match all the fuels with the equipments that are required to produce heat. Till then, do your work. Okay, bye-bye. See ya.